First thing we're going to do is just our basic stationary dribbling. We use time. You could have the guys dribble it for 10 counts or 30 counts, whatever. But we use time, so we're going to go for 30 seconds. Now, we probably won't go for 30 seconds on these. All right. If you got two balls, you got one ball, just dribble one ball, just pound it straight up and down.
Push on them, make it hard for them, disrupt them.
partner to you. Now we're gonna dribble cross court. Dribble cross court. When you get on this side, you switch partners and go back. So Jordan and Emil, one of you guys jump in, one of you guys jump out. Alright, here we go. Get on their shoulders. Now we're just gonna try to dribble across court. Just putting some pressure on it, making it difficult for him. And switch partners and go ahead and dribble back. I want you guys right out here, lane line extended, move into some partner passing drills, just one basketball per group of two. With that dribbling stuff, it's something we'll try to do about every day. We can spend about 10 minutes on it. Again, they're just touching the basketball, working on control and handling the basketball, getting better with the basketball in their hands. Now, first thing we're going to do is just simple passing drill. Basics, fundamentals. We're just going to make a chest pass. Now, when you catch the ball, I want everybody to pivot with a forward pivot towards that goal. So you're going to turn forward towards the goal. All right, chest pass. Here we go. So just basic, simple partner passing drill. When they catch, they got to square up and look at the goal. If you have a younger age group, elementary kids, I'd encourage you to try to do something like this every practice. Just have them pass the ball, catch the ball, and pivoting. All right, now we're gonna go bounce pass, and reverse pivot. So instead of forward pivoting, step back, open up, and still use the goal. Use the goal on your side of the court. Still squaring up, still facing the goal, but you're reverse pivoting now. Hayden's got the basketball, he's gonna throw it over Tyler's head. Tyler's gonna go get it and jump stop. He's gonna pivot, forward pivot, chest pass, and then he's gonna run back in line. They're gonna switch partners, they're gonna throw it to the other guys. In the basketball game, we accelerate and decelerate. Go ahead, just jump stop, forward pivot, jump stop, forward pivot. Go ahead, put a little air under it. In the basketball game, we accelerate and decelerate all the time. Something that we don't really think about, but we're doing it all the time. You can kind of teach your guys how to do it correctly, particularly the deceleration, the jump stop or 1-2 stop. It's really important that they work on it. All right, switch up your stop now. Instead of 2 feet jump stop, I want you to go 1-2, 1-2. Now this time you're going reverse pivot and bounce pass. Reverse pivot and bounce pass. So you just kind of change up what they're doing, make them work on something else. 1-2, reverse pivot, bounce pass. Hustle back in line. Yeah, don't throw it across the court. Now, this is a bad way to get them warmed up, too, because they're hard to start beating. They'll get tired of doing this, chasing the ball. Alright, hold up. Now, come back out here where you're lined up with your partner passing drill. What I want is 3 basketballs per group of 2. So you need to get a couple more basketballs. 3 basketballs. We'll do a little more advanced ball handling passing drill here. Alright, here's what we're going to do. You're going to dribble one ball with your left hand, and then you're going to pass the other ball right hand to right hand. So partner passing, just right hand to right hand, but dribble the ball with your left hand.
Devontae Stain, he just scored. I don't think he's in these guys. All right, here we go. Pick it up. There's two. Catch and pivot. Catch and pivot. Don't travel. All right, so then red would do push-ups. Okay? All right, so that's 4-on-3, 10 passes. Now you can go 2-on-3 if you only have 6 or 7 guys in practice. Just make one extra defender. Again, you can restrict it as much as possible. No score, no dribble. They just have to work on being tough with the basketball. Okay, now we're going to change the game, okay? Let's even up the numbers. So we have 5 on each side. Logan, come back out here for me. Or Hayden, come back out here for me. We'll just go 4-on-4. 4-on-4, so. All right, now here's what we're going to do. We're going to play tag, okay? But here are the rules. White's on offense. White, you're on offense, but you cannot dribble the basketball. What your job is, and don't do it yet, but you're going to pass the basketball to each other, and you're going to try to touch every guy in a red jersey. Okay? So we're playing tag, but you cannot dribble the ball. Okay? We did this in conditioning a couple weeks ago. You got to be creative, you got to have great spacing, and you have to have a plan here. Okay? Now, we're only going to go for a minute. If you don't get them all tagged in a minute, we'll move on. But it's just basketball tag, okay? White's on offense, you're trying to tag the guys in a red jersey with the basketball. You just have to touch them. You can't throw the ball on them, you just have to touch them. All right, Ray, you're trying not to be tagged. Trying not to be tagged. Don't travel, White. Here we go, go. Good job, tag. Amigo, don't get tagged. Basketball, basketball. Good job, don't travel. White, you got it. You got to go get next to a red. You got to get next to a red. Good job, almost. Jordan, get it. There you go. Good job. You got to stay next to a red. There you go. There it is. You got two more. You got two more. Move the ball. He's out of bounds. Watch it. Get on the court. Get on the court. You got to stand next to a guy. You can't travel. Get it. There we go. Good job. Jordan, stay next to it. Nah, you can't do that. There we go. You got 13 seconds. You got 13 seconds, right? Get next to him. Get next to him. You travel. You got 5. Game over. Mike's got pushups. Mike's got pushups. Again, it requires them to think a little bit, to space, to kind of have an idea of what they're doing on the court, and they have to be able to catch without traveling. You got to be able to catch a move without traveling. All right, let's see what's next on the list. All right, we're going to do some combination dribbling and finishing drills. So everybody grab the basketball. I'm just going to be a regular two-line layups. Two-line layups drill. Okay. Yeah, we'll just go with everybody here. Except for the guys on the rebounders. You guys don't need it. All right, now, probably the most basic layup drill ever created, just two-line layups. Now, we actually have 4 different ways they're going to finish. You guys just go ahead and start. Just go off of one leg. First one is just traditional layup off of one leg. And then when Javante gets back to the front of the line, he's going to go off of 2 feet with a pump fake. So it's just traditional layup off of one leg. Then when Javante gets here, he's going to jump stop, pump fake. Good job. Off of 2 feet, jump stop. You're getting chased in the open court. Jump stop, pump fake. Defender flies by. Easy basket. Now the third one is a reverse, so when he gets to the elbow, he's going to cross over and shoot with the opposite hand on the other side. Again, as your guys get bigger and stronger, defenders start chasing them. The ability to use the rim kind of protects the opportunity to get a shot from a shot blocker, the ability to block your shot going through the rim. Now, our fourth shot is just a pull-up jump shot right at the block off the backboard. Kind of old school. But if somebody's trying to draw a charge, they're just waiting right in front of you, trying to get the guys to pull up, knock down a jump shot. Now, they've got all kinds of moves. They've got a Euro step. They like to go off the opposite leg. They've got a variety of other things they'll do. But those are the four shots that we work on. Okay. Yeah. Now, we would switch over to left. We're not going to do that today. What we're going to do is go into Bronco layups. We got two lines out front and two lines on the wings, and then we need three basketballs. We need a line, a ball in Hayden and Logan's line, and then we need a line in Jordan's line. Now, Jordan, bring your line up more, free throw line extended. Hayden, slide your line up higher. And then Javante, move your line back here. Yeah. Tyler, start holding up the white volleyball court line here. All right, now, let me kind of describe what's going to happen here. Tyler's going to go guard to guard, and then he's going to cut hard at Jordan, okay? And then we'll just shoot those four layups again. Come back here, Tyler, and start over. First one, we're just going to shoot off the 1 foot. Next time they shoot it, they'll go off the 2 feet, and then they'll go reverse, and then they'll do a little pull-up, okay? All right, we call this Bronco layups. Here we go. It says guard to guard, and then they're working on cutting hard. You gotta cut hard, and they're just working on finishing at the rim. Good job. Now make sure you guys are rotating lines, just go to the line. You carry your ball too. Go to the line, you carry your ball too. Good job. Oh, you can dunk it if you want. Just traditional layup off of 1 foot right here. Yeah, take it to the line you're heading. All right, Javante, when you're up, go off at 2 feet. Javante, when you shoot, go off at 2 feet. And then we just work those four finishes out of this drill right here.
Retreat, crossover. one or two moves at the middle level.
Thank you.
Logan, just slide that one up by the Bronco head. That'll be the one that we attack coming back. And Logan and DeMarcus will need a basketball. All right, this is what we call full court L cut. We'll show you here in a minute, but to get open on the wings, we work L cuts. We get our guys to come up to the elbow, plant their foot, and slide here. Okay, so it's a drill that kind of incorporates passing and pivoting, finishing on this end, and then kind of a speed dribble, full court finishing drill on the other end. Okay, so these guys, after they make a pass, they're just going to switch lines. Javante's line will go here, Tyler will end up there. Emil, after he shoots, will be down at that end. Elijah will jump in that line. So this is a full court help pack drill. All right, here we go, Elijah. Go. Catch and pivot. Good job. Good job. Call for the ball. Make it forward pivot or reverse pivot.
Thank you.
either Tyler or Elijah, you gotta run because you're going with Jordan. Hold up, you guys go grab a quick drink. Go grab a quick drink and I'll do some shooting. Again, if you only have half court, that's probably not going to be such a great drill for you, but if you're working with somebody else and you can practice in a full court situation, we used to play 3-on-2, but we weren't getting the opportunities. I guess our defenders are either cheating or running pretty hard because we weren't getting what I wanted as far as just a transition shot. So we went 3-on-1 and that seemed to give us what we were looking for. But that's a fun drill. Now, you can also go 3-on-3. Just put 3 defenders back and then you can work on football with help. You can work on a transition drill where maybe you hit a wing and then you set a down screen on the backside. But again, it requires full court. In a little bit, when they get back here, we're going to work on shooting. And I don't know what you guys do specifically to teach shooting. When your guys are little, sometimes it's really, really hard to get them to work on the correct form, depending on the height of the goal they're shooting at. What I would encourage you to do is just have 2 or 3 main points. The first point is make sure their toes are pointed towards the goal. A lot of kids are standing sideways and they're shooting there. Make sure all 10 toes are pointing towards the goal. You want them to be balanced. They don't want to be falling backwards or they want to be drifting to the right or to the left. And that's why I use the acronym BEEF. Guys, just stand still for a minute. B just stands for balance. All 10 toes pointing straight towards the goal and that they're on balance. The first E is their elbow. Now, again, it's one of those things, when they try to pick up a basketball and shoot at a 10-foot goal, they may shot with it, right? If you've got it, a lower goal, 7 or 8 feet, and they can work on good balance, put their elbow next to their hip, that's gonna be best. Now, as they get older, as they get stronger, it'll be easier for them. The second E is their elbow should finish above their eyeballs, or their eyebrows. When they shoot, their elbow should be above their eyeballs. A lot of kids shoot with their hands straight out in front of their face. You know, their elbow is below their nose, below their chin. Try to get their elbow above their eyeballs. And then the final F just stands for follow through. Just want to try to turn their hand over. So we talk about BEEF, balance, elbow extension, and follow through. And then the other piece is just be prepared to shoot. Doing your homework before the ball arrives. Getting that good balance, that good base, and you can just catch and shoot. So we're going to run through some shooting drills. And hopefully these guys demonstrate some good shooting form. All right, 2 balls right here. We're just going to go Shriner shooting to start with. Shriner shooting. Just 2 basketballs. And just shoot elbow jump shots.